And Srila Vyasadeva is an empowered incarnation of the personality of Godhead. He wrote so many books. He wrote the Srimad Bhagavatam. He wrote Mahabharata. He wrote 18 Puranas.
他撰写了很多的书籍，他撰写了《Srimad Bhagavatam》，他撰写了《Mahabharata》，他撰写了十八部《Purana》。
And he divided the one Veda into four.
而且他把一部伟大经典一分为四。
So Srila Vyasadeva was certainly a very great soul, and Vidura is born, he's the son of Vyasadeva, one of the sons of
Vyasadeva.
And he was born in the royal family there, although he was born in the womb of a Sudra woman, but he was born in the royal palace at Hastinapur.
他出生在皇室的家庭,尽管他生子一个书者的女仆,但是他出生在 Hastinapur的皇宫里。
So Dhritarashtra and Pandu were the two brothers, and Vidura is also like their brother. They're all born by the semen of
Vyasadeva.
And Vidura, it is said that he is Yamaraj, because Yamaraj was cursed to come. He was cursed to come as a sutra. He was cursed by the great yogi. What was the yogi's name? There was a yogi. He was living in the cave, and a gang of dacoits came to live in the same cave where he was staying. And the soldiers, the military police, they came and they arrested all these dacoits, and they arrested the yogi also, because they thought the yogi was with all these dacoits. And they all got taken to court, and they all got sentenced to death. And in those days, they had a very interesting way of killing the criminals. They would have to walk up on a board, and they had to walk onto upraised spikes. There were vertical spikes up, and they had to walk onto these spikes. So they would fall off the board onto these spikes, the whole body would be pierced in these spikes.
在那个年代，人们有一种非常有意思的就是死刑的方法。他们必须要走在一块板子上，然后从板子上掉下去。板子上面竖着竖直的长矛，这样他们的身体在掉下去的时候就会被这些长矛刺穿。Not
a very pleasant way to leave the body.
这不是一种离开躯体的另一愉悦的方式。So
they were all sentenced to death, and this yogi also, he had to walk onto these spikes, and And at that time the king came, and he heard that there had been a great mistake made, and the yogi was actually a great yogi and he wasn't a criminal, and the king came and he apologized to the yogi.
就在这个时候国王来了，国王发现大家犯了一个错误。 他们这个把Yogi也抓起来，然后这个Yogi实际上是一个非常伟大的Yogi，所以国王把他放了，并且向这个Yogi道歉。They
picked the Yogi up off the spike, and the king offered his obeisances and apologized to him.
他们把这个Yogi从这个长矛上边，就是把他抱起来，然后呢，国王向他顶拜，向他道歉。And
the king was very repentant, very apologetic, and the yogi accepted his apologies, but the yogi went to see Yamaraj to find out why this had happened. And Yamaraj told him that when he was a young boy, he was very naughty. And he would take a blade of grass and pierce insects with it. So the punishment, the karma was that he was to be pierced. So the yogi thought this was a very harsh karmic reaction. He thought, I was only an innocent child at the time, I didn't know what I was doing. So he cursed Yamaraj that he should become a sutra. So this was a blessing for Yamaraj because Yamaraj's job is not very nice.
其实对于 Yamaraj 来讲是一种祝福, 因为 Yamaraj 的工作并不是一件很好的事情。
He has to punish, he has to meet all these sinful people and he has to arrange the punishments for them.
他要惩罚人, 他要去见所有这些罪恶的人, 还要为他们制定惩罚的方法。
Right, put this one in Kumbhipaka Loka, fry him in burning oil.
好吧, 把这个人放到 Kumbhipaka Loka, 然后把他在这种滚热的油锅里煎炸吧。
So many horrible hells are there and suitable punishments for all the sinful people.
有很多非常可怕的地狱, 就是为了惩罚那些罪大恶极的人。
And Yamaraj is a devotee. He actually likes to hear the glories of the holy name. He likes to hear about the Lord in its different incarnations.
Yamaraj, 他本身是一位奉献者, 他非常喜欢聆听主的圣名的荣耀。
So he was anxious to get a break from his job. Sometimes, you know, the jobs, the work which people have to do is not very pleasant. Being a mother, for example, bringing up children is not very pleasant sometimes.
比如说成为一位母亲, 养孩子, 有的时候你会觉得这是一个苦差事。
Very difficult.
很困难。
Vidura is really a great devotee, and he came back to visit palace. The Pandavas, and he wanted, his purpose was really to live, to get Dhritarashtra out from his condition. So when he came there, when Vidura came there to the palace, he was greeted by Maharaj Yudhisthira. Maharaj Yudhisthira said, Bhavad Vidir Bhagavatas Tirtha Bhutam Swayam Vibho, Tirthi Kurvanti Tirthani, Swantastena Gadavritaha. Maharaj Yudhisthira is glorifying Vidura and he is saying that you are yourself the personification of the holy places because you carry the Lord in your heart.
献上了一番祷文，意思就是说，您是非常值得受到崇拜的，因为您本身的显现就像是圣地一样，因为您一直在您的内心之中承载着主的莲花足。
And wherever you go, you purify that place.
无论您去哪个地方，都会净化那个地方。
Just like Mother Ganga, wherever Mother Ganga flows, she purifies that place.
就像是恒河母亲一样，无论恒河母亲流淌到哪里，它都会净化那个地方。
Of course, a lot of sinful people take advantage to come and bathe in her waters.
当然了，有很多罪恶的人，他们会利用这一点到恒河母亲的水中沐浴。
But a lot of very pious, saintly persons also come and bathe in her waters.
但是也有很多非常虔诚的这些非常好的人士，他们也会到他的水里去沐浴。
And they take away all the bad, all the sinful reactions of the impious people.
他们会消除所有那些不虔诚的人所造成的坏的影响。
So Narottamdas Thakur, he recommends that people shouldn't go to holy places.
Narottamdas Thakur, 他不建议人们去圣地。
He said there's, in the Kali Yuga, people are, they're so sinful, they don't behave properly, they don't know how to live in the holy place.
他说在卡利优格，人们并不知道应该如何的好好在圣地生活，他们的行为举止非常的有罪恶。
But Srila Prabhupada says that for the common man, there's a great benefit to go to holy place.
但是Srila Prabhupada说，对于普通人来讲呢，他们是有必要去圣地的。
Narottamdas Thakur says that People should just simply remember Govinda. Wherever they are, they should simply stay and remember the Lord. If they go to holy places, they may get influenced by all the nonsense and all the wrong philosophies which are being propagated there.
如果人们去圣地的话，他们便会受到在圣地大家所宣传的那些错误的哲学影响。
Sometime, one devotee was telling me, we were in Kanai Natsal. He was telling me that on Ram Nomi, they get a lot of people coming there, very big crowds, a big festival.
我们在卡纳纳的沙拉的时候，有一个奉献者跟我说，在那Ramanovami的时候，会有很多的人去那个地方。And
he said, you get all philosophies, all different kinds of groups, all different sahajyas and apasampradayas, they will all come there.
他说你会接触到各种各样的哲学，所有的这些宗教的团体，各种的sahajya们、apasampradaya们，他们全都会去那里。And
if you don't know how to distinguish, you may be influenced by these kind of people.
如果你要是不知道如何分辨的话，你就会受到这些人的影响。We
don't know who is actually bona fide and who is not.
我们并不知道谁是正宗的，谁不是。Just
like there was this one Babaji, he was called Charan Babaji, and he was living in Jagannath Puri, and he was going to associate with Bhaktisiddhanta and Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
就像有一位巴多吉，他的名字叫做查兰巴多吉，他住在加格纳特布瑞，他经常去跟Srila Bhaktisiddhanta 还有Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 一起联谊。
But then this Babaji decided he wanted to make a new mantra, and he composed his own mantra.
但是这位巴多吉后来决定他自己要创造一个新的 mantra， 他于是就编纂了他自己的 mantra.
And told his followers, don't chant the Maha Mantra, just chant this mantra.
他告诉他的追随者们说，不要唱诵Maha Mantra，只唱诵这个mantra就可以了。
And Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, they both told him that this is nonsense, that this is very wrong, but he wouldn't listen to them.
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 和 Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur 两者都告诉他这是非常错误的，你不应该这样做。
But he wouldn't listen to them.
但是他不听他们的。
And he's got his own followers, and they've got temples even today, it's still going on.
他有他自己的追随者，有自己的庙宇，直到如今这种情况还在继续。
And then you've got people like Sakibeki, which is a philosophy where the man dresses like a gopi.
还有一种人叫做 Sakibeki， 男人打扮成Gopi的样子。
And they think that they can assume their rasa with Krishna while they're in this body. They want to take their spiritual body.
他们自以为处在目前的这个躯体之内的时候，便可以恢复跟 Krishna的这种 rasa。
And so you get some men dressing up as Gopis.
这样你就可以看到一些男人打扮成Gopi们的样子。
And they say, oh, now I'm Lalita Gopi, this is Vishakha Gopi.
我现在是 Lalita Gopi, 这位是 Vishakha Gopi.
And this way they are trying to present, teach the message of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which is not really true, it's not the message of Chaitanya.
如此他们便呈现着朱彩檀的 Mahaprabhu的讯息, 但实际上这并不是朱彩檀的 Mahaprabhu的真正的讯息。
So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he identified 12 different kinds of apasampradayas.
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, 他一共指出了12种不同的 apasampradayas.
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to challenge all these people and expose them all and to present the real teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 想挑战这些人， 想去揭发这些人，并且呈现出主师Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的真正的教导。
But you've got so many other people, they'll say, no, we know what is the real message of Mahaprabhu. They will present something else and say, this is the real message of Mahaprabhu.
但是有其他的一些人，他们说，我们知道Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的讯息是什么，这才是Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的讯息。
So in the Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes evam parampara praptam imam raja shiovidu sakalinihyan mahata yoga nashta parantapa. That the knowledge was delivered through the line of the disciplic succession, but in course of time, the knowledge was lost. Yoga nashta means that the line was broken, the knowledge was lost, people stopped following.
Yoga nashta 的意思，这个传承已经被中断了，人们停止去追随。
They didn't like to follow exactly as it was taught. They had their own ideas about how to follow.
他们并不想按照这个被教授的方法去追随，他们有自己的怎么去追随的想法。
Yeah, we don't like this mantra, we're going to chant and we're going to make a new mantra.
我们不喜欢这个 mantra, 我们要自己编一个 mantra.
Just like in China, there was that lady from Mudanjung, and she said, Krishna told me, Bhagavad Gita is old, I should write a new one.
就像在牡丹江，在中国有一个老太太，她说：“Krishna告诉我。”她不是老太太，我们也说她是老太太。有一个女士她说：“Krishna告诏我的，巴格丽塔已经老了，现在我要写一本新的书。”Yeah,
she wasn't old. She was a middle-aged woman.
她并不老，是一位中年的女子。But
she was a rascal. She took our process and mixed her own process and wrote her own nonsense book. And so many blind followers came to follow her.
但她是一个混账，因为她采取了我们的体系，然后创办了她自己的体系，有很多人盲目的去追随她。And
they gave her a lot of money.
而且大家给她很多钱。She
became a very rich woman.
她变成了一个很富有的女人。
She was very poor. And she's not going to be very rich for long. Krishna will take everything away from her. And at the time of death, she'll be in big trouble. The cheaters will find a cheat. If somebody wants to be cheated, they'll find a cheater.
骗子，也就是说，如果一个人想被骗的话，他就会遇到一个骗子。Prabhupada
would say only two classes of people: the cheaters and the cheated.
他说这个世界上只有两类人：骗子和被骗的。And
so sometimes people misunderstand the Krishna consciousness movement and think we are also bogus. They think we are also cheating.
有的时候，人们会误解 Krishna 知觉运动，他们认为我们也在欺骗，我们也是骗子。
We have to show them that we are actually preaching the truth and we practice what we preach.
我们必须要向他们表明，我们所传播的是真理，而且我们修习我们所传播的内容。
The example has to be shown. The example speaks louder than words.
必须要做出榜样，因为亲身的榜样胜过千言万语。
Just telling people not to do things is not enough. They have to see the example from the leaders.
只是告诉人们不应该做什么，这还不够，因为人们需要从领袖的身上看到你是怎么做的。
So all of the devotees are actually leaders. They have to show the example to everyone.
所有的奉献者们实际上都是领袖，他们必须要向其他的人展示出自己的榜样。
If we don't show the right example, then we can't expect people to follow.
如果我们不好好的做出榜样的话，怎么能够指望着其他人来追随呢？
So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught by his example.
主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu就是通过他的榜样来教导大家的。
Vairagya Vidya Nija Bhakti Yoga. He taught devotional service based on detachment from the material and transcendental knowledge. So we're trying to show people what is actually the proper system, the proper process of devotional service.
因此我们在努力地向大家表明真正的这个体系是什么，真正的奉献服务到底是什么。
It is not just only going to the holy place to just take a bath there.
并不仅仅是去圣地，然后在那里沐浴。
Many people may come here to Mayapur, they come, they take a bath, they see the deities, they eat prasadam, But the real purpose in coming to the holy place is to hear from the devotees.
很多的人他们来到Mayapur沐浴看神像吃菩萨的，但并不是真正的目的。真正的目的是应该去聆听去联谊。And
not only is that in Mayapur where people need to hear, but all over the world people need to have the opportunity to hear the message of Krishna consciousness.
并不仅仅是在玛雅普人们需要去聆听，在全世界人们都需要聆听 Krishna 知觉的讯息。
Lord Chaitanya gave great importance to hearing.
主舍坦内非常强调聆听。When
he asked Ramananda Roy to give the verse about the ultimate from the scriptures, give a verse from the scriptures about the ultimate goal of life.
他让Ramananda Roy 引证经典，举出一个诗节，提到人生的最终极的目的是什么
？Right? Who knows the verse?
谁知道那个诗节
？Anybody know the verse?
有人知道这个诗节吗
？Nobody knows the verse.
没有人知道这个诗节。
你十八章？啊？你十八章？十八章？
嗯？十八章？十八章？ No, from Bhagavad Gita, from Srimad Bhagavatam. Lord Chaitanya was not satisfied with the verses from the Bhagavad Gita. He told him, keep going. And then finally he came to a verse from the 10th canto, Lord Brahma.
他说继续，终于出现了，在第十篇主
Lord Brahma speaks about, he says, stay in whatever position you are in.
主布拉玛提到的这个世界里说，无论你身处什么样的处境，
some people think they have to change. No, you know, I should become a sannyasi, or I should become a vanaprastha.
有的人认为自己应该改变，哦，你应该成为一个sannyasi，我应该成为一个vanaprastha。
But Lord Chaitanya says, just stay whatever position you are in.
但是主舍坦内说，只是，无论你身处什么样的境况，你都待在哪个情况里。
Hear about Krishna in the association of devotees.
在奉献者们的联谊之中，聆听 Krishna.
Hear about Krishna in the association of devotees and strictly follow the principles, the regulative principles.
在奉献者的联谊之中聆听 Krishna， 并且严格地追随这些规范原则。
And by hearing about Krishna in purified association, then you can conquer Krishna.
通过在这种被净化的联谊之中的聆听，一个人便可以征服 Krishna.
Krishna is Ajita, unconquerable.
Krishna 是 Ajita， 不可被征服的。
But he becomes conquered by the devotee who hears about him with pure love and devotion.
但是他会被一个充满了纯粹的奉爱之情的奉献者的聆听所征服。
So Lord Chaitanya heard this verse, he said, ah yes, this is devotional service.
主舍坦内听到这个世界之后说，啊，是的，这才是奉献服务。
He didn't accept Savadharma Pargita. He didn't accept that verse from the 18th chapter. He said, well, people may surrender for other reasons.
他并不接受巴格基特16章里的那个世界萨尔巴达尔玛，是因为他说人们可能会因为其他的原因而臣服。
We get many people want to come to the Krishna consciousness movement. They want to come and live in the temple. They think it's a good place to eat and sleep.
有很多的人他们进入 Krishna 知觉，他们来到庙里，是因为他们觉得这是一个很好的可以睡觉、吃东西的地方。
Not everybody comes with the motive that I'll come and work for Krishna and I'll spread Krishna consciousness.
不是所有的人来的目的都是想着我要为 Krishna 而工作，我的目标是为了传播 Krishna 知觉。But
they're thinking about their material situation.
他们想的是自己的物质的情况。So
that's why nowadays in ISKCON they're more cautious, they're more careful about bringing people into Krishna consciousness.
这是为什么现在在 ISKCON 之内，大家都很小心的把大家带到这个 Krishna 知觉之内。
Sometimes women come. And they come, you know, they bring their child, you know, they bring a child and they come to Krishna consciousness. And they're thinking, I'll get another husband.
Mm-hmm.
So we get these kind of situations everywhere.
在所有的地方都有这种情况发生。
But Lord Chaitanya didn't want that kind of surrender.
主舍他们并不想要那种类型的臣服。
So he said to people, stay where you are, whatever position you're in, you stay in that position.
他说无论你身处什么样的境况，你都待在那种情况之中。
Hear about Krishna in the association of pure devotees.
在纯粹奉献者的联谊之中聆听 Krishna.
So then Lord Chaitanya said, now go on from that.
主舍他们接着说，从现在开始，从这一点接着说。
So then Ramananda Rai went on to explain about different levels of devotional service.
接着 Ramananda Rai 开始解释出在不同层面的奉献服务。Right,
we know there's different rasas. There's Shantaras, just like the four Kumaras. They're in Shantaras.
我们知道有不同的 rasa, 就像是普马尔斯兄弟他们住在 Shantaras之中。
And then there's Sakyaras, you've got people of Dasharas, after Santaras and Dasharas, Krishna's servants.
在Santaras之后便是 Dasharas, 也就是Krishna的仆人。
Right? Who are Krishna's servants?
谁是Krishna的仆人?
Do you know the name of any of Krishna's servants?
你知道Krishna的任何仆人的名字吗?
He's a Rama, he's a servant of Rama.
他是Rama的仆人。
Who is the servant of Krishna?
谁是Krishna的仆人?
Sudama.
Huh? Who?
Sudama.
Uddhava? Well, Uddhava is mixed friendship. A little, you know, it's some friend, it's more friendship. Some.
Arjuna.
Tulasi.
Tulasi? No.
Arjuna
is a friend.
Arjuna is a friend.
Yeah.
Who is his
friend?
Daruka. Yes. Right. Daruka. Krishna's chariot driver. And in Vrindavan, Krishna's servants are Raktak.
Vrindavan, Krishna's servants are Raktak.
Patrak.
Patrak.
Bhadrak.
Bhadrak.
Yeah, they're all Krishna's servants in Vrindavan. And then Krishna has his friends, of course. As Achyutananda Prabhu said, Uddhava is a friend, but he's a friend not like being equal, but he gives respect to Krishna.
Uddhava, 但是Uddhava呢, 他不仅仅是一个朋友, 他更多的是给 Krishna一些敬意, 不是说在平等的层面上。
He's Krishna's secretary, and Krishna will often ask to Uddhava, what do you think, and what should we do?
他好比 Krishna的秘书, Krishna经常问他, 你觉得怎么样, 我们应该怎么办?
Sometimes Prabhupada would ask devotees, what do you think? What do you think,
Gopi
Gita? What should we do?
有的时候，Prabhupada也会问奉献者，你觉得怎么样？Gopi
Gita，你觉得怎么样？我们应该做什么呢？So Prabhupada would ask devotees. Devotees would just, oh, Ochi Prabhupada, I don't know.
当妈妈这样问奉献者的时候，奉献者就是，哦，爸爸，我不知道。
Not very. Tomorrow Krishna Maharaj, he couldn't. He would talk.
他猫为什么还是他会回答，他知道怎么去应对这个，他不告诉他。有的时候，爸爸会问其他的奉献者，然后他们非常的惶恐，哇，爸爸。
So Uddhava would never sit on the same level as Krishna.
所以乌德瓦从来不会坐在跟 Krishna 同样层面的这个座位上。
If they went to a house, someone's house. Krishna would sit on the cushion and give Uddhava a cushion. Uddhava would sit on the floor. He wouldn't sit on the cushion.
比如说，他们一起去一个人的家里 ，Krishna 坐在一个垫子上，但是 Uddhava 他会坐在地上，他不会坐在垫子上。
He wouldn't want to sit on the same level as Krishna because he considered himself subordinate to Krishna.
他不愿意跟 Krishna 坐的一样高，是因为他认为自己是 Krishna 的下属。
But then there are other friends of Krishna, like the cowherd boys, who enjoy great intimacy with Krishna.
但是还有其他的朋友，就比如说那些牧牛童们，他们跟 Krishna 一起享受非常亲密的关系。
And we see also Arjuna, he also had some intimacy with Krishna. They would lay on the same bed, and they would eat together, and Arjuna would joke with Krishna also.
我们可以看到 Arjuna 跟 Krishna 也有亲密的交往，他们会躺在同样的一张床上，然后他们可以坐在一起。有时候 Arjuna 还会跟 Krishna 一起开玩笑。
And then you see in the 11th chapter when Krishna showed the universal form, then Arjuna felt shocked and he was apologizing, but, oh, please forgive my offenses, I did not understand your position.
接着我们可以看到在巴洛菲的第十一章里，当 Arjuna 看到 Krishna 的宇宙形体的时候，他就在道歉说，哦， Krishna, 我不知道你的地位。
So, sometimes,Krishna will cover himself with yoga maya so he can enjoy more intimacy with the devotee.
有的时候 Krishna 会让 yoga maya 来覆盖自己，这样他可以跟奉献者享受更亲密的逍遥时光。
So the cowherd boys, for example, they play with Krishna, they wrestle with Krishna, they ride on Krishna's back, they put their feet all over Krishna.
那些牧牛童们，他们跟 Krishna 交往非常的亲密。比如说，他们可以跟 Krishna 一起打闹，可以骑在 Krishna 的背上，可以把自己的脚踩在 Krishna 的身上。
And then you've got parental rasa, vatsalya rasa, and you have Vasudeva and Devaki, and you have also Nanda and Yashoda.
接着有父母的这种 rasa, 也就是 vatsalya rasa, 在这方面有 Vasudeva 和 Devaki, 还有 Nanda 和 Yashoda.
Of course, Vasudeva and Devaki, they're not on the same level like Nanda and Yashoda.
当然了 ，Vasudeva 和 Devaki 跟 Nanda 和 Yashoda 的层面是不一样的。
But they're all eternal Nitya Siddha devotees, perfect devotees.
但他们全都是永恒的 Nitya Siddha 奉献者，都是完美的奉献者。
Vasudeva and Devaki are in Vaikuntha, and Nanda and Yashoda are in Goloka.
Vasudeva and Devaki 在 Vaikuntha, 而 Nanda and Yashoda 在 Goloka.
And we see when Lord Krishna appeared in Mathura, it was Vasudeva and Devaki, they were offering prayers to Lord Krishna.
我们看到当 Krishna 显现在 Mathura 的时候， Vasudeva and Devaki 在向 Krishna 献祷文。
But Nanda and Yashoda, they don't offer prayers to Krishna.
但 Nanda and Yashoda 他们是不会向 Krishna 献祷文的。
Because their mood of parental wrath is so deep, it's not like Vaikuntha.
因为他们的这种父母之情的 rasa 非常的深，就是很深很深的，不像是 Vaikuntha 的那种。
We see Mother Yashoda how she can chase Krishna and she can tie up Krishna, and so many past wonderful pastimes with Krishna and Mother Yashoda.
我们说亚修的妈妈，她可以去追 Krishna, 去抓 Krishna, 然后把 Krishna 绑起来。Yashoda Mama 和 Krishna 之间发生了很多奇妙的逍遥时光。
And the same way you see Lord Chaitanya with his parents, Jagannath Mishra and Sachimata.
同样道理，我们可以看到 Lord Chaitanya 的父母 Jagannath Mishra 还有 Sachimata, 他们跟主也有很亲密的交往。
And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a young boy, he was very wild and mischievous, and he did many tricks and pranks, and people were complaining.
其实，在马哈普布小的时候是非常的淘气的，他做了很多的恶作剧，有很多人给他告状。
Anandama, Jagannath Mishra would sometimes want, he would chastise his son.
Jagannath Mishra 有时候要责怪他的孩子，责怪他的儿子。
And then, when Jagannath Mishra would go lay down and go to sleep, in his dream, a brahmana would appear to him and tell him.You should not talk to your son like that. You do not realize his identity.
当 Jagannath Mishra 躺下来睡觉的时候，他梦见有一个 Brahmana 出现在他的面前，跟他说：“你不应该那样对待你的儿子，因为你不知道他的身份。”
But Jagannath Mishra would say, "I am his father. It's my duty to chastise him."
但 Jagannath Mishra 说：“我是他的父亲，我的职责就是去责罚他。”
And Jagannath Mishra.Often chastise Nimai Pandit.
Jagannath Mishra 会经常的去责罚 Nimai Pandit.
So that is Vatsalya Ras, and then you have Madhurya Ras.
那边是 Vatsalya Ras, 接着是 Madhurya Ras.
And we have the gopis, we have the Krishna's wives, and you have Parakya Ras, and Swakira.
在这方面，Gopi们还有Krishna的妻子们。 是Padakiras还有Swakiras.
Swakiras means married, in marriage, husband and wife, or Krishna married with his wife, that's Swakira.
Swakiras就意味着丈夫和妻子之间的这种情感, 也就是说他们是结了婚的,这个叫Swakiras.
And then you have Parakiras, which is Krishna with the Gopi.
而Parakiras指的就是Krishna跟Gopi们之间的关系.
Of course, the Parakiras is even more pleasing to Krishna.
当然了，Parakiras甚至更加的取悦Krishna.
It gives Krishna even more pleasure.
这甚至给Krishna带来更多的快乐.
The excitement, the whole sensation of having some kind of illegal connection with the opposite sex.
这种激动的这种感觉就是跟异性有一些非法的关系。
So what is the lowest thing in the material world is the highest thing in the spiritual world.
在物质世界之内最低贱的事物实际上是在灵性世界里最崇高的事物。
So Ramananda Rai was explaining about the gopis, and then of all the gopis, of course, there is one gopi who is above all the other gopis, and that is Srimati Radharani.
Ramananda Roy 在解释所有的这一切，当然在所有的Gopi之中，有一位Gopi超越所有其他的Gopi，他就是 Srimati Radharani.
And Lord Chaitanya said, "Yes, let's hear about this Gopi. Tell me about this Gopi."
主Chaitanya他说，让我们聆听一下这位Gopi的事情，请告诉我关于这位Gopi.
And Ramananda Roy went on to describe all the wonderful qualities of Srimati Radharani.
于是 Ramananda Roy 开始描述 Srimati Radharani 的所有的奇妙的品质。
And he described about how Lord Krishna, when he performs Rasa Lila, he dances with all the gopis. And he has one gopi on each side, one on the left side, one on the right side.
他描述到当 Krishna 做 Rasa Lila 的时候跟 gopi 们一起跳舞，他的两边，左边一个 gopi， 右边一个 gopi。
But he has Radharani, just him and Radharani.
但是当他跟 Radharani 在一起的时候，只有他跟 Radharani 在一起。So
Krishna would enjoy even more pleasure with Srimati Radharani than with any of the other gopis.所以
Krishna 在跟 Radharani 在一起的时候，那种享受要超过他跟所有其他 gopi 们在一起得到的这种享受。And
sometimes Krishna and Radharani would disappear.有的时候
Krishna 和 Radharani 会消失。And
it said at that time. They would go to Kanainathsala.
据说在那个时候，他们会去Kanainathsala.
Kanai is the name of Krishna.
Kanai 是 Krishna 的名字.
And Nathsala means the place of dancing.
Nathsala 的意思是一个跳舞的地方.
So, Srimati Radharani and Lord Krishna would sometimes go to Kanainathsala to dance.
因此，有的时候 Srimati Radharani 还有 Krishna 他们会去Kanainathsala去跳舞.
There are two qualities of Srimati Radharani which are most appreciated by Lord Krishna.
在 Srimati Radharani 身上有两个特征是主 Krishna 最欣赏的.
What do you think?
您觉得是什么？跳舞.
Yes, one is the dancing.
是的，一个是跳舞，cooking，做饭。
Yes.
是的。
Cooking and dancing.
做饭和跳舞。
So Srimati Radharani excels in these two.
Srimati Radharani 在这两个艺术的方面是非常的优秀的。
She got the blessings of Durvasa Muni that whatever she cooked would be just like nectar.
她得到了Durvasa Muni的祝福，无论她做什么、烹调什么，做出来都像甘露一样。
So, when Mother Yashoda knew that Srimati Radharani had been blessed in this way, she invited Srimati Radharani that she could come and cook for Lord Krishna every day.
也说的妈妈当她听说了Srimati Radharani得到了这个祝福之后，她就邀请Srimati Radharani每一天来为主 Krishna做饭。
Lord Krishna would go out into the forest and he, you know, in the morning he'd pack a lunch bag and he'd go out into the forest with the cowherd boy.
主 Krishna 早晨的时候会带上他的仓盒跟那些牧牛童们一起去森林里放牛。
And then they would come home in the evening and Srimati Radharani would have cooked their evening meal.
然后他们会在晚上的时候回来, 而 Srimati Radharani 会把她的晚饭做好。
She would be cooking all day.
她一天都在做饭,
making wonderful preparations just for the pleasure of Krishna.
做出各种各样的美味佳肴, 就是为了取悦 Krishna.
So cooking for Krishna is one of the important arts of devotional service.
因此为 Krishna而烹调是一项非常重要的奉献服务的艺术。
And family life also is important. Woman should be a good cook. She should cook nice for her husband.
在家庭生活之中，这也是非常重要的。女人应该成为一个好厨师，她应该为自己的丈夫做饭。
Sometimes, of course, the husband cooks for the wife.
但是有的时候，丈夫为妻子做饭。
Sometimes the wife is the breadwinner. She's making the money. She's doing the work.
有的时候因为妻子在工作，她在挣钱，她在干活。
It's not so every day that you know the husband's off to work. Often it's the husband that's home, the wife is working.
那么丈夫不用天天出去工作，丈夫在家，妻子去工作。
One devotee just wrote to me, he's at home, and his wife is making 10,000 rupees a month.
有一个奉献者告诉我，写信说他天天待在家里，他的妻子每天出去每月挣10,000人民币。他说我就在家里管家。种点菜。And picks her up at night, drives the car, picks her up from work at night.
Could imagine the wife that, oh, so tired, what a day. The husband has to, never mind. Anyway, everyone has to do their karma. Some people have good karma, some have bad karma.
无论如何，每个人都要按照自己的karma行事，有的人好的karma，有的人有坏的karma。
We all have to get free of karma by surrendering to Krishna.
我们全都要通过臣服于Krishna而消除我们所有的karma。
That is the real goal of life.
那才是生命的真正的目标。Yajnata karmanan yatra loka yam karma bandana tadatam karma kontiya mukta sangha samacharam.
Work done as a sacrifice for Vishnu has to be performed. Otherwise, that work binds one to the material world.
作为祭祀而进行的活动必须要被供奉给Krishna，否则的话，这种活动就会让一个人被束缚在物质世界之内。
So everyone has to work. You have to do some kind of work, whether you work at home or you go out to work. But everybody's going to be doing some kind of work.
每个人都要活动，或者是说工作，或者你在家里活动工作，或者你要出去活动工作，每个人都必须要做。
Everybody's got to going to do something. You cannot just simply do nothing.
每个人都得做点什么，你不能无所事事。
Everybody's going to eat, and they're going to walk around and talk, and we're going to do so many different activities. We can't stop.
每个人都要吃饭，每个人都要讲话，每个人都要走路，你必须得做点什么，不可能说就停止在那儿。
Lord Krishna explains in the Bhagavad Gita, no one can be idle, not even for a moment. All men are forced to act helplessly due to the impulses born of the modes of nature.
主 Krishna 在《Bhagavad Gita》之中解释说，每一个人都不可能无所事事的这么待着，每一个人都会因为他跟物质自然属性的这种关系而被迫的要去做某种活动。
We have to transcend the modes of nature. We have to come to the platform of pure devotional service.
我们必须要超越物质自然属性，必须要达到纯粹奉献服务的层面。
We have to hear Krishna regularly.
我们必须要有规律的去聆听 Krishna.
We have to be reading Prabhupada's books very carefully. We have to try to take part in all the activities which are going on. Join the Kirtan party.
努力地去参加Kirtan的这个队伍。
Try to hear Srimad Bhagavatam.
努力地去聆听 Srimad Bhagavatam.
Try to distribute the message of Krishna consciousness.
努力地去派发 Krishna 知觉的讯息.
So the preaching here in India is certainly expanding very, very well.
在印度这里的传播的工作很显然进行得非常好.
In the month of May, there will be the opening of a very big temple.
5月份的时候，大家会开一个很大的庙.
In the month of May, there will be Akshaya Tritiya. Akshaya Tritiya is an auspicious day.
5月份的时候有一天叫做 Akshaya Tritiya, 这一天是非常吉祥的日子.
It's a day in which people may begin their business, or they may get married on that day, or they may also buy jewelry and gold on that day.
这一天呢，人们会开办他们自己的生意，有人会在这一天结婚，或者有的人会在这一天去买金子、珠宝、首饰什么的。
You're going to buy some gold?
你们都要去买金子吗？
Well, it's a good day, Akshaya Tritiya. And anyway, we're opening a big temple in Pune.
这是一个好日子, Akshaya Tritiya. 无论如何，我们在Pune要开一座大庙。
Not Pune, Patna.
不是 Pune, 是 Patna.
Pune is already opened, right?
Pune is open.
That's Maharashtra.
那个是马哈拉斯特拉邦.
But this is in Bihar.
这个是在比哈尔邦.
Which is not very far away from Calcutta. It's the next state.
离加尔各答并不远，就是挨着加尔各答的一个邦.
And they built a huge temple.
他们建了一座非常宏伟的庙.
At the cost of 80 crores.
花了80 crores, 8亿卢比.
A crore is 10 million.
一crore是1000万.
So 800 million.
八亿.
So it's a lot of money. It's a big temple, very big place.
很多的钱，很大的庙宇，很大的地方.
So it's a big program. They're trying to get the Prime Minister of India to come.
而且他们举办很大的节目，他们想去邀请印度的总理来参加.
So that's in Akshaya Tritiya.
就在 Akshaya Tritiya 那一天.
Which is in the month of May.
就在5月份.
Fourth of May.
Huh? Fourth of May.
5月4号。
Yeah. So, opening big temples is not the goal, but it's helping on the path towards the goal.
开办大的庙也并不是目标，但是这个会帮助我们的目标。
It's not just only build the temple.
并不仅仅是建庙。
But we have to also have nice devotees to preach there and to present Krishna consciousness.
我们必须也要有非常优秀的奉献者在那个地方传播，来代表，来呈现Krishna知觉。
We want to bring everyone into Krishna consciousness.
我们想让每一个人都能够进入到Krishna知觉之中。
We want people to have a good appreciation for the Krishna consciousness movement.
我们想让人们好好的去欣赏Krishna知觉运动。
Just like when Lord Chaitanya came to Mathura, Lord Chaitanya was. He'd been traveling and he came to Mathura and he went to the Adikeshava deity. It was the first place he went to in Mathura. So he began chanting and dancing.
他开始唱诵并且跳舞.
On his own, one person, he was just chanting. Hare Krishna.
就他自己一个人在唱诵Hare Krishna.
And everybody, people are watching, you know, looking.
周围的人都在看的.
Who is this sannyasi? Who is he?
这个sannyasi是谁？他是谁？
But then this old brahmana saw him, and the old brahmana came and began to dance with him.
然后来了一个年迈的Brahmana，而这个年迈的Brahmana开始跟他一起跳舞。
And Lord Chaitanya was surprised, because usually people would only just look, nobody would join. But this person, this Brahmana, old elderly man, came and began to dance with Lord Chaitanya. So Lord Chaitanya kept dancing and chanting, and the Brahmana was dancing with him. And after some time, then Lord Chaitanya finished the kirtan.
于是朱彩丹的一边唱一边跳，而这位年迈的布拉姆呢跟他一起跳舞。过了一段时间之后，朱彩丹就结束了他的kirtan.
So then, after they finished the kirtan, Lord Chaitanya brought the Brahmana aside, and in a quite private place, he asked him. He said, "My dear Brahmana, please tell me, who are you?"
在kirtan结束之后，朱彩丹呢把这位年迈的布拉姆呢带到一个僻静的地方，他问他。 请问你这位Brahmana到底是谁?
And the Brahmana said, "I am a disciple of Madhavendra Puri. Madhavendra Puri was traveling here, and I brought him to my house. I fed him, and I took initiation from him."
然后这个年迈的Brahmana说，我是Madhavendra Puri的门徒。我见到了他之后，把他带到我家里，我给他吃菩萨等，然后他启迪了我，我是他的门徒。
And when Lord Chaitanya heard that, he fell at his feet, offering obeisances to him.
当朱彩丹听到这番话的时候，他立刻跌拜在他的足下，然后向他顶拜。And
the Brahmana was, "Oh no no, what? Please, just a minute. You're a sannyasi. I'm just a fallen grihastha. Please, don't you bow to me."
这个Brahmana说，哎，等等等，不要不要，我只不过是一个很堕落的一个 grihastha， 而你是一个 sannyasi， 请你不要顶拜我。你在干什么
？But Lord Chaitanya said, "No, you're the god brother of my spiritual master."
但是朱彩丹也说，你是我的灵性导师的灵性兄弟。
Right? Who was Lord Chaitanya's guru?
谁是朱彩丹的guru?
Ishvara Puri, right?
Ishvara Puri, 对了。
And who was Ishvara Puri's guru?
谁是 Ishvara Puri的guru?
Madhavendra Puri.
Madhavendra Puri.
So, Lord Chaitanya understood that this Brahmana was chanting and dancing because he had had association from Madhavendra
Puri.
Without that contact with the devotees, then people have no understanding how to chant the holy name and how to dance in ecstasy.
如果没有跟奉献者这种接触，人们便不知道应该如何的唱诵圣名，如何的在狂喜之中跳舞。So,
Lord Chaitanya said that the example, someone's example reveals the actual nature of a person.
所以朱彩丹呢，他树立了一个榜样，他去向人们展示这个。Behavior
of a person shows actually what is the standard of his devotional service.
一个人的行为举止的这个标准，实际上体现出了他的奉献服务处在什么样的境界。
One who is a devotee of Krishna will have all the good qualities of Krishna.
一个人如果他是 Krishna 的奉献者，他便具备 Krishna 的所有好品质。And
one who is not a devotee, then they won't have good qualities.
如果一个人不是奉献者，他不会有任何的好品质。They
may be very good in maintaining their family.
他们可能非常善于维系自己的家庭。Or
they may be very expert in mystic yoga.
或者他们很擅长练习玄秘的瑜伽。But
if they're not devotees, they don't have any good qualities.
但如果他们不是奉献者的话，便不具备任何好品质。So
it's understood that if one is actually a devotee, he has to acquire all the good qualities.
所以要明白，如果一个人是奉献者的话，他便获得了所有的好品质。Now,
of course, it's going to take some time. It's not going to be immediate.
当然了，需要一段时间，不是立刻的。You
become a devotee. It's not that now you're a devotee. You put on necklace immediately. You change.
不是说你现在成奉献者了，戴上了净珠，马上改变。No,
it's going to take some time.
不是需要花一段时间的。We
have to come to the higher stages of devotion.
我们必须要达到奉爱的更高级的阶段才行。
just like in devotional service, there's different levels of devotion.
就像在奉献服务的过程之中，有不同层面的奉献服务。
Beginning with faith and then coming to association with devotees.
先从信心开始，接着是跟奉献者们的联谊。
And then learning to do devotional activities.
然后去学习做奉献服务。
And then getting rid of all the anarthas.
然后是摆脱所有的 anartha.
And then coming to the stage of being very steady in our Krishna consciousness.
然后达到这种在 Krishna 知觉之中非常稳定的状态。
And then getting taste for these activities.
接着对于这些活动产生品类。
And then becoming detached from all material things and becoming fully attached to Krishna.
然后不依附于所有这些物质的事物，完全依附于 Krishna.
And then coming to the stages of bhava and prema.
然后达到 bhava 和 prema 的层面。
And so even in the beginning, somebody is chanting the holy name. He's begun the process.
甚至在一开始的时候，人一旦开始唱诵圣名，他便开始了这个程序。
But he has to keep going.
但他必须要不断的继续努力。
If he stops, if he give up, then our devotional service is suspended.
如果他停止，如果他放弃的话，那么他的奉献服务也会终止。
After some time, they may come back.
过一段时间之后，他可能会再回来。
But they don't continue. It's going to again. They will start from where they left off.
然后他们要从他们落下的地方再接着捡起来。
They don't lose anything.
他们不会失去任何的东西。
But they waste a lot of time.
但他们浪费很多的时间。
We have to begin it. We have to come back again, and then we again take up devotional service.
我们必须要再次回来，再次的重新拾起奉献服务。
So sometimes people are very proud. They have a lot of knowledge, and they think, "Oh, this knowledge, this is so too. I've already studied all of this before. You know." This is not very satisfying to me.
有的时候人们他们会很骄傲，他们有很多的知识，他们就觉得这些东西我全都知道了，这些是不能满足我的。
If I have to take part of the Bhakti Shastri course, oh, it's just so basic. Everything is so basic. I don't get anything out of it.
如果我去参加 Bhakti Shastri 的课程。这些都是基本的东西，我从中得不到任何的益处。
But if I get to explain, I can explain not everything to other to the all the other people.
但是我可以向其他的人去解释所有的一切。
I can tell them that what is the scriptures all about. I know all the contents.
我可以给他们讲经典到底是什么，我了解其中所有的内容。
So in this way, you know, they're feeling that, you know, I'm not getting any sense.
这样他们就会感到我没有得到任何的满足。
So I was telling the devotee that the real purpose of the Bhakti Shastri course is not just to give you knowledge.
我在告诉奉献者们 ，Bhakti Shastri 这门课并不仅仅是给你知识。
But it's to train you to work with devotees and to get along with other devotees and to be part of a team.
而是说让你得到训练，你能够跟其他的奉献者一起，你能够成为这个团队的一部分。
Not just to acquire knowledge, not just to memorize things.
并不仅仅是为了获得知识去记忆一些东西而已。
But to be able to use what you've learned.
而是说应该去运用你所学到的内容。
And to be able to work with different devotees on different levels.
而且能够按照不同的层面跟不同的奉献者来打交道。
Sometimes people think I'm educated. I know all these things. I've read all these books. I know everything.
有的时候人们就会觉得这些教导我都读过了，所有的东西我全都知道。
And then they'll say, when I go to the China, what is it, the cultivating the Daojiao or the.You know, Confucius, the Kongzi, you know, the moral principles and all these different things. They view this as much more satisfying to me than reading the Bhagavad Gita.
这样的人就觉得，比如说，以后去中国，然后研究一些道教啊，或者是孔子的那些道德的教导，这个比读《巴格瓦蒂塔》更让他感觉到满意。
But there's no mention of Krishna in any of these things.
但这在这些内容之中没有谈论到跟Krishna有关的东西。
It may be Chinese culture.
可能是一种中国文化。
But there's no Krishna consciousness.
但是其中并没有Krishna知觉。
So that's a problem.
这是一个问题。And
you're feeling satisfied. What you're satisfying, you're satisfying your material intellect. You're not satisfying your spirit soul.
你感觉到满足，其实你满足的是你的这种物质的智性，你并没有去满足你的灵魂。We
have to understand what is the need of the soul. The soul is a part of Krishna. We have to connect to Krishna.
我们应该明白到灵魂的需求是什么，灵魂是 Krishna 的一部分，我们必须要跟 Krishna 连接在一起。So
it's not just knowledge.
所以并不仅仅是知识。Just
having a lot of knowledge, a lot of information, but there has to be proper realization.
有很多的知识，很多的信息是没有用处的，应该有恰当的觉悟。You
have to be able to apply the knowledge.
你必须要能够应用这门知识。
Okay, any questions?
好了，大家有什么问题吗？
Narottama-dhan-dhaku说，这个年代最好不去生，学了《花花》书，像我们这样的人最好来生，绕拜圣地，Parikram-Sahari，这个层面的度念者绕拜圣地有什么好？
因为我在网讲课，国内朋友问，你讲那么多绕拜圣地，绕拜圣地到底有啥好处？What
benefit can we derive from Parikrama?
Well, Narottam Das Thakur was advising that we should just simply fix our mind on Krishna.
Narottam Das Thakur 建议是我们仅仅应该将心意专注在 Krishna 身上。
And he says it's probably better that we don't go to the holy places because there's so many imperfect beings, there's so many deviations in the holy place.
他的教导是我们最好不要去圣地，因为在圣地呢有很多的有不完美的生物体，而且他们的行为举止有很多的偏差。
And better people just stay in their own home and chant Hare Krishna on their own rather than get association from all these deviations.
最好还是好好的待在家里，自己念诵，而不要出去，然后被那些偏离所误导。But
Prabhupada said, for the common man, it's still good to go to holy places.
但是帕普拉说，对于普通人来讲，去圣地还是有好处的。Because
common men are not able to remember Krishna.
因为普通人是不能够意念 Krishna 的。They
don't think of Krishna.
他们不会想着 Krishna.
So they need to go to the holy places.
因此他们需要去圣地。
And they go to the holy places and they get Krishna consciousness. They get a heavy dose of Krishna consciousness.
他们去圣地，他们可以得到 Krishna 知觉，他们可以得到重重的 Krishna 知觉的剂量。
And the benefit of going on the parikrama is that it's an opportunity to get detached from the material world.
而参加 parikrama 的好处便是让一个人可以不依附于这个物质世界。
Because generally we're very attached to our home and our little house and apartments, and we don't want to go up. We get attached to passing stool in the same place every day. Prabhupada was, he saw that the stool droppings were under the tree, and Prabhupada said to the devotees, what does this tell you?
然后他指着树下的那些粪便，然后问奉献者们说，这告诉你们什么呢？
Prabhupada, stool droppings.
然后奉献者就说：“这底下这些都是鸟粪呢。”
Prabhupada said, I know what it is.
爸爸说我知道这是什么。
But what does this tell you?
但这个告诉你什么呢?
So we get very attached to the material world. But parikrama is a chance to get detached.
但是 parikrama 是一个不依附的机会。
To go out and walk, just to walk in the holy place, everywhere, you know, we want comfort, we want everything to be very nice and very very gentle and easy going. I should be nice and comfortable. And you go out on parikrama and it's not like that.
我们出去走路，本来我们都是希望生活非常的舒适，非常的容易的。但是我们去做 parikrama 的时候，完全跟这个不一样。
So it's very good for us to get a little austerity to get purified.
对于我们来讲，这是非常好的一件事情。我们做一些苦行，能够得到一点净化。
Everybody has to do some austerity in order to get purified.
每一个人都应该做一些苦行来得到净化。
So going on parikrama is a purification.
所以出去参加 parikrama 实际上是一种净化.
It's also an opportunity to do devotional service. It's serving the lotus feet of the Lord.
而且这也是一个奉献服务的机会，这个是相当于服务主的莲花足.
So we want to do all these different angas of devotional service, right? One of them is Padasevanam, so we do Padasevanam by going on parikrama.
我们应该做奉献服务的不同的anga，不同的这些方面。那么其中的一项是 Padasevanam， 我们可以通过做 parikrama 来进行这一项服务。
And we also have the opportunity to see the places of the Lord's pastime.
而且我们还可以得到机会去访问主的不同逍遥时光的地点。
And to hear what pastimes were performed in these different places.
并且得到机会聆听他在这些地方上演了什么样的逍遥时光。
In the actual place, we actually hear, just like we hear about, you know, Srivas Pandit and where they were doing kirtan every night.
就像我们听到 Srivas Pandit 每一天晚上他在什么地方做 kirtan.
We heard how the Chankasi came there and broke the Madanga.
我们听到 Chankasi 又怎么去了那里，把 Madanga 打破了。
You can go there to Srivas Angam, you can see the broken Madanga.
你们可以去 Srivas Angam, 你们可以看到被打破了的 Madanga.
Right, the broken Madanga is there.
被打破的 Madanga 就在那里。
The Chankasi came there and broke the Madanga.
强卡子去了那里，打破了 Madanga.
So we hear about these things, and it's easier for us to remember and to relate to them when we actually go there and see.
那么我们听说了这些之后，当我们实际的去那里去看的时候，就更容易跟这些就是培养起一种关系来。
Just like before Kumaras, they were sons of Brahma, and Lord Brahma was telling them about the Supreme Lord and devotion to the Supreme Lord.
就好比是库马尔斯兄弟，他们是主布拉玛的儿子们。主布拉玛教导库马尔斯兄弟关于去尊主的这个奉献服务是什么。But
the four Kumaras, they were just thinking Brahman. No, no, it's okay, we're happy with the Brahman.
但库马尔斯兄弟们只想着布拉曼，我们对布拉曼就已经很高兴了。But
then when they went to the spiritual world, and they actually saw Lord Padmanabha, when they saw the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then they understood, oh, this is it, yes, we have to be a devotee.
但当他们到了灵性世界的时候，他们终于见到了主帕特曼纳巴，然后他们终于明白到了，哦，这是主啊，我们应该成为奉献者。There
was a change in their heart and in their mind, and they understood, wow, yeah, we have to become devotees.
在他们的心里还有心理之中发生了转变，他们明白到，是的，我们必须成为奉献者。
So they say, with some people, they come to Mayapur, and when they see Mayapur, and they see Radha Madhava, and they see Panchatattva, and they go on Parikrama, and they hear all the holy places, all the pastimes, the holy, then they understand. This is the spiritual world.
同样道理，有人来到了Mayapur，然后他们看到了神像，他们聆听，他们参加Parikrama，于是他们便明白到，哦，这就是灵性世界。
But sometimes we live here in Mayapur and we're thinking, I want to go back.
但是我们在Mayapur住久了，我们有时候就会想着，哦，我要回中国。
So we have to understand that how fortunate we are to be in this holy place. After many, many lifetimes, we have this chance. The spiritual world.
这是灵性世界。
The place of mercy. Yes.
仁慈之地。
你谈到绕拜圣地是一种苦行，一般人都喜欢做自己喜欢的，不喜欢做自己不喜欢的。苦行是不是意味着我得做这个我不喜欢的服务？有的时候我喜欢的服务还不能做，由于某种原因，这叫不叫苦行呢？
No. What is the meaning of austerity?
苦行的含义到底是什么?
Austerity is tolerating some inconveniences for the service of Krishna.
苦行意味着为了服务 Krishna 而忍受一些不便。
Actually, we're thinking, I like this service or I don't like this service. That's our mind we're thinking.
我们想着我喜欢这个服务，我不喜欢那个服务，这些都是来自于我们的心意。
Some people are very happy to go in the kitchen and cook.
有的人很高兴去厨房做饭。Some
people are very happy to get the opportunity to offer arti.
有的人很高兴得到机会可以去供奉arti。Some
people are very happy to go out on parikrama.
有的人很高兴得到机会去参加parikrama.
All the young boys from the Gurukula, they would come out every year on the parikrama.
孤苦了的那些小孩们每一年都会出来参加parikrama.
And they would be walking the whole way.
他们一路都走着。
We'd be staying out every night.
每天晚上都在外面睡。And
they love it. They think it's great, wonderful.
他们很喜欢，他们觉得这太棒了。
They never think any kind of austerity. Somebody else thinks, oh, too austere.
他们从来没觉得有什么苦行的，其他的人可能会觉得，哦，太苦行了。
So what is austerity? That's a very relative thing.
苦行其实是一种非常相对的概念。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes about austerity of the body and the mind and words.
在巴格吉特之中，主Krishna描述了躯体、心意和言语的苦行。Right,
Lord Krishna describes what is austerity actually. He said, worshipping superiors.
主Krishna描述到底什么构成苦行，比如说，崇拜长辈。
Just like parents, right?
就像是父母。
Children should give respect to the parents.
孩子应该尊敬父母。
And we worship the spiritual teachers.
我们尊敬灵性的老师。
That is one austerity of the mind. Then speaking words which are truthful.
而且要讲真话。
Reciting scriptures.
朗诵经典。
This is austerity of the tongue, using the tongue to recite scripture.
这些是舌头的苦行，用舌头来朗诵经典。
So austerity is not torturing the body.
苦行并不是对躯体进行折磨。
That's austerity and ignorance.
那是处在愚昧之中的苦行。
We want to do austerity in goodness.
我们想做出善良之中的苦行。
So describe for us in the Bhagavad Gita what we should be doing.
因此，在巴格吉特之中描述了我们到底应该做什么。
第十七章。你没有提问，我能不能再问？接着问。那个现在是中国的清明节，就祭祀祖先。大多数中国奉献者认为祭祀祖先还是有用。然后我们作为一个奉献者，我们知道服务。